Hello, my name is Garrett Barmore. I'm the curator of the W.M. Keck Earth Science and Mineral Engineering Museum, and welcome to Mineral Monday. Today we are at the Steamboat Geothermal Complex, and I am with John Akerley, who's the Senior Resource Engineer at Ormat, and Jim Faulds, who is the Director of the Nevada Bureau of Mines and Geology at the University of Nevada, Reno. Okay, well let's go look around. So Jim, what can you tell me about geothermal in Nevada?
Yeah, well, geothermal is a form of renewable energy. And what you're doing is basically harnessing the Earth's heat where it comes into contact with water, heats up that water. So kind of harnessing the heat and hot water. And Nevada has vast amounts of geothermal energy. And it's a very low carbon footprint, a great form of renewable energy, and lots of potential to develop more in the area.
What is this that we're standing on?
Well, we're actually standing on what's called a sinter or silica terrace. And it's where the hot fluids have sort of leaked out onto the surface and they've deposited silica. And when we see silica on the surface like this, we know that the temperature of that geothermal system is relatively high. In this case, about 180 Celsius, or that's about 350 Fahrenheit. So it's a good indicator that we have had hot fluids in this area before. And when fluids are that hot, then you can harness that for generating electricity. And what's really neat about this terrace too, you can see the cracks in the terrace. And that's a good indicator that the crust is actually being stretched apart in this area. And so what's really interesting about Nevada is that it's actually the fastest growing state in the country, tectonically speaking. And we're actually adding about a couple of acres or so every decade or so to the Earth's crust in this area. That's one of the reasons why Nevada has so much geothermal energy.
So John, what exactly is the Steamboat Geothermal Complex?
Well, the Steamboat Geothermal Complex is actually made up of six different power plants that cover all the way close to the highway, all the way back down to the top of the hill. And those six power plants generate 65 megawatts of electricity on average. And there are 25 production wells that feed each of those plants. As Jim said, the geothermal fluid is moving closer to the surface in Nevada. So we have wells drilled anywhere from several hundred feet all the way up to a few thousand feet in this whole field. And what we do is pump that geothermal fluid, which is very hot, and it runs through a power plant, and we boil a working fluid, pentane, which is part of the binary geothermal generation process. And this is an efficient way to extract the heat from the fluid and then also get to re-inject everything that we produce right back into the ground so that it can go through the life cycle of recovering the heat from the Earth's rocks and coming right back to the wells where we produce it again.
What people don't, a lot of people don't realize is that there's about 24 of these power plants across Nevada producing, well, the capacity is to produce on the order of almost 800 megawatts. And 1 megawatt is enough energy for up to about 1,000 homes. So that's a lot of renewable energy being produced in Nevada. And this particular plant sits right on the south side of Reno. Overlooks Reno, and again, many people are unaware that we have this great renewable energy resource right on the edge of town.
So you said that we have about 24 geothermal plants in Nevada. So does that mean that we have found all the geothermal resources in our state?
No, as it turns out, that's not the case. So most of the developed systems are in areas where we knew there was hot water in the area, generally due to hot springs at the surface. But what's really interesting is that we now know that most of our geothermal resources are hidden beneath the surface with no surface hot springs. And so we're doing a lot of research now at the Nevada Bureau of Mines and Geology to understand where those hidden resources are, how we might identify favorable areas for future exploration and future drilling. And so there's really a vast amount of this resource in this region that is still undeveloped.
If you would like to learn more about the Steamboat Geothermal Complex, visit ormat.com. And to explore the amazing geothermal resources in Nevada, visit the Nevada Bureau of Mines and Geology website at nbmg.unr.edu. Thank you for joining us on this fantastic tour, and we'll see you next on Monday.